Hello! Back out of Clouds RC here, coming to you from the man cave again. Well, I got the Thunderbird all put together. A 5,000 will fit in there, but it's very, very tight. I didn't have to do any carving, but the canopy just fits in there. But, I mean, it's tight. So, really, probably a 4,000 would be better, 3,200 up to a 4,000. But a 5,000 will fit. CG on the plane, according to the manual, which is, I just use the manual as a starting point. So from 90 to 110 millimeters back from the leading edge where the front of the wing touches here on this corner area, right about here. So it's going to put it back about right about here. So anyways, play with that back with four. I think a 5,000 is going to need to go back a little bit further, because if I put my finger on the CG, it's really nose heavy. And with a jet, you want it to be level to slightly, ever so slightly tail heavy, but mainly level and just hair tail heavy. That way you can do your high alpha landings and without any real problem. Jets are a little different than your prop planes. Nose cone just pops right. This was probably the easiest build I've had. I use a product anytime I'm gluing foam. Now, what happened to it? I just had it. I want to show you a product that I use. It's DAP Fuse. Now, I get this at Walmart, or I ordered a two-pack of this for like 15 bucks from Amazon. It's perfectly foam-safe with a light blue lid, and it's like, it sets in 30 seconds. It's got the strength of a 5-minute epoxy, but it's got the ease of use of CA. It's like a medium CA. And test fit your foam pieces together, take them apart, put a nice thick layer of this, put it back down, pull up real quick, and then put it right back down again, and it ain't coming apart. All these, the servos and everything had the only servo you had to hook up back here was the rudder, and it has that locking pin, so many of you could hit light to light, which is easy. That set right down in there. I took a little bit of sandpaper or a sanding block, and where the elevators attach and where the rudder attaches, I just sanded the bottom of that. Took my 2mm hex drive, which is what you use to put the wings on, scored up the inside of the foam areas where it touched, put a nice layer of this wrapping fuse down, and that's in there. The wings bolt in, same locking servo connection, and then these winglet bonds just slide right on, typical fashion. Had absolutely no problem. I put safe on my H here, and literally retracts on this thing. Let's put the canopy back on. Plenty of room for batteries for sliding around, and but I think 4,000 would probably be best for it, or maybe a 3,200, like I keep saying. These fins, you only glue the back section in. The front section you do not glue in, because when this comes off, you want to be able to access your EDF if you need to. But nice working, fins, or nice working gear. They do have some suspension to them, so that's nice. She was perfectly trimmed. Look at the elevator. Got plenty of control with the elevator. Plenty of movement with your ailerons. And you see your rudder's got plenty. Right now I've got it set at 100% with no expo. Now what I will be doing as far as rates, I'll be doing my typical rates. I'll be doing 100% over 30% expo for high. Mid will be 80 over 30, and then low will be 70 over 30, and that'll be all the way around. Now with jets, they're a little more touchy. I might go maybe to a 20% expo, but for right now, I'll stick with 30. 30 seems to be my happy spot for almost everything, even stuff that flies fast. And as I get better with this plane, I want to have a little more precision, I might go to a 15% expo. But for right now, I'll stick to 30. and see how we how I like it. Probably take her up the first time in the 70 over 30 rate, and then if I'm comfortable with that, I'll go to the 80, and if I'm still comfortable, I'll go to the 100 with 30% expo all the way around. She's got plenty of power. Definitely more than a 1-for-1 ratio. So, you know, skyrocketing to the moon will not be a problem. Good looking model. You got cheaters all around as far as to air intake. There is absolutely all these services were absolutely perfect to trim right off the bat. I didn't have to adjust. The only thing on the ball links for the both halves of the elevator, the pieces of the push rods, the snap link, the ball links, the parts that snap on, I had to turn them just a little bit so they would line up with the balls on the ball link. Let me show you that real quick. And right here, these push rods where they connect to the ball link, I had to turn them just enough where they lined up perfectly to snap in. That was the only adjustment I did on both sides. That was absolutely the only adjustment. The rudder is perfectly level. The aileron's perfectly level. Everything lines up. The elevators are perfectly level now. And the only blemish on this plane was that little piece of red overspray right here on this left wing here. So I can't say anything bad. I took her out the driveway. Of course, it's the middle of the night right now. It's like, you know, 3:30 in the morning. And I just drove around my driveway, and tracks perfectly. Nice and straight. Absolutely no problems at all. So there you go, folks. It went together wonderfully. I'll be honest, I didn't even use the manual. I looked at it afterwards to make sure I did anything right, but yeah, I had. Just make sure that when you hook in your servo lead for your rudder, that you hook light to light, dark to dark. You may even want to go ahead and bind the model up and make sure it works before you commit to blue. I trust E-Flite, so I didn't do that. But, if first time building a plane, make sure you check that first, okay? The car, and then hook up light to light, you lock in, it's obvious. You won't be able to screw that up. It's got a nice plastic cone back here for exhaust. Lots of plastic reinforcements all over the thing. It's got, of course, it's got the carbon fiber rod that just slides in. The wings slide on. They lined right up. You know, sometimes when you're putting a wing on, you kind of have to adjust it back and forth to get the screws lined up. Not the case here. A two millimeter hex drive drove in the four screws. And they, first time. No problem at all. I can't, as far as the build, it has been the most easy, enjoyable build. I'm just disappointed that it went so quickly. I enjoy putting them together. So, like I say, the radio setup, I selected my H channel. Now, this is the older style where you have to hold the bind button down if you want to have safe, which I have safe on H. You hold the bind button down, you bind, you keep your finger on it, and then once the transmitter says you're all bound, then you take your finger off the bind button. So you kind of have to be, you know, ambidextrous and have two things going, but it's not hard. And then I assigned H. Now, don't be surprised. Now, whenever you bind her up and you fire up the motor, your throttle cut needs to be below, down to -130, and then you'll have immediate, you don't have to calibrate anything. But when you go and you fire up and you get up over 25% throttle to activate the AS3X and you don't have safe on and you think nothing's happening, the AS3X correction is very subtle. You can feel, you have to put your hands on the control surface and move the plane, and you can feel the little bit of pressure that the ailerons give off, and you can visually see the correction in the rudder and the elevator. So don't, but you don't hear it. You know, lots of times these planes, You can hear the gyro, you know, but you can't hear them with this, but it's working. I can feel it working in the AS3X. So don't Don't be thinking, well, my safe works. My AS3X don't work, and that's what I wanted. It does work. It's just very subtle. And with this plane, as stable as it is, it's fine. Okay, you don't have to worry about that. But can't think of anything else. Of course, oh, it's got all plastic around your air intake here. You've got really good cooling. You got cooling that comes up through here. There's a vent here underneath. Goes up over your battery, goes through. Everything's going to stay nice and cool and taken care of, Father. You won't have any problem. The 5,000, I guess, will be fine, but you're going to have to move it back. Way too nose heavy. But I just can't wait to fly. I just got to have, it's going to probably be a couple weeks before I have a day off to where I can get out and give a good maiden on this. So here it is, Mother's Day of 22. Well, no, it's actually the day after. And early Monday morning, but I just can't wait to get her out and fly her, get you a maiden. It's been a wonderful build. It has been no problem at all. I can't say anything bad about it. It's just been a really, really good, very good experience, very positive, very happy, and I can't wait to fly it and get you and show you what this plane can do. Now, this is Fat Guy Flies RC saying thank you for watching. I appreciate you, and please remember, faith, family, friends. Bye-bye.
Gotta turn the camera off now.